Here's your wrap of news from the week gone by. The center recently formed India's first National Council for Transgender Persons under the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act 2019. The council will be headed by the Union Social Justice Minister and consist of representatives from 10 central departments, 5 states, and members of the community. While members of the trans and intersex community welcomed the decision, they also highlighted the problems in the way the council members were selected. I am glad that a member from the Northeast region has been appointed to be a part of the council. However, there was no transparency in the manner in which the members were selected. This is a matter of concern, said Santa Kurai, a trans rights activist based in Manipur. Women's share in the National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, NREGS, has dipped to an 8-year low at 52.46%, according to an analysis of the data available on the NREGS portal till August 24. The analysis revealed that this was the lowest share of women in the scheme since 2013 and 14. Out of the 13.34 crore active NREGS workers, 6.58 crore, that is 49%, are women. As per a news report by Indian Express, no official reason has been provided for this record low, but sources indicate that this is due to the increased participation of men following the return of migrant workers to their native villages due to the COVID-19 pandemic. A 17-year-old Dalit girl was found dead near her house in the Lakhimpur Kheri district of Uttar Pradesh on Wednesday. According to the police, the minor had been raped before she was killed. She had left her home to fill out a scholarship application early on Monday morning. This is the second such case in 2 weeks in the Lakhimpur Kheri district. On August 14, a 13-year-old Dalit girl was allegedly raped and murdered in the same district. Opposition leaders have raised serious concerns about the law and order situation in Uttar Pradesh in the wake of several reports of gender-based violence in the region. According to recent data from the Union Health Ministry, India has once again seen a record daily rise in COVID-19 cases, with nearly 78,000 fresh cases being recorded in the last 24 hours, bringing the total count to nearly 34 lakh cases. An additional 1,057 new deaths brought the overall death count to 61,529. India has the third highest number of COVID-19 infections in the world, after the United States and Brazil. A recent study suggests that empowering local communities to manage forest restoration can be a just and sustainable way to deal with climate change. The study, the result of a collaboration of experts from the Indian School of Business, the University of Manchester, University of Sheffield, Dartmouth College and University of Michigan, was published on Monday in the journal Nature, Ecology and Evolution. The study highlights that nearly 300 million people worldwide lived on land where tropical forests could be restored, and that it is important to empower them to sustainably fight against climate change.